One of the best things about advising Evocart is seeing students outside of class getting really passionate about something. The best thing I can do is set the team up for success so they can kind of lead themselves and run the team as a small business and tap into their own creativity. One of the impressions of a school like OSU is it's large, and we are large. We like to say comprehensive. At a smaller school, you're gonna have one or two projects like you see behind me. At OSU, you've got seven or eight. If you want to work on cars, we've got that. Underwater robotics, we've got that. Robots of all sorts and flavors, we've got that. One of the things that students are sometimes worried about is access to faculty or getting lost in a large university. With these types of projects that Dennis and his colleagues are working on, there we have meetings probably three or four times a week where I'm working with them. We're doing hands-on stuff. We're doing the theoretical stuff and project management, business, communications, all of that. So there's a lot of opportunities to mix with faculty and researchers at a large university. So one of our students, and this is not uncommon, had a job offer a year and a half before he graduated to go into one of the really elite groups inside of General Motors. If you're graduating from a school with a bachelor's degree, you're competing against thousands of people with undergrad bachelor's degrees in engineering. But if you are already prepared to do the job that you're interviewing for, that improves your odds of getting that specific job so much.